relationship.
I'm gonna be real. I believe that, I always discuss this, I feel like I'm one of the old fashioned type of guys, where as soon as I find me a woman that doesn't mind the fact that I want to be in charge, and that I believe that, just like with the...
Good afternoon. Welcome to the velo-ads YouTube channel. This is part two of our new series, Me and My Bike. And I am with the number one YouTube vlogger who used to vlog about human powered vehicles, ice trikes, and his mad adventures. And he's also a famous author. I can hear him chuckling in the kitchen. I've been laughing for the last hour. I've got to try and keep a straight face. The most famous author in Uxbridge. Where's he gone? Oh, he's the most famous author in Hayes. We are with the legendary, one and only, Graham Williams.
This is my best side. I got the Vortex, but that was a young man's bike, really, with the 26-inch wheel.
At the back, yeah.
It was okay once you got going. It was brilliant. I mean, I used to chase two-wheel bikes.
Was it quick off the mark?
No, that's the problem, you see. It needed so much effort to break that inertia with a 26-inch wheel from the standstill. By the end of the day, I was knackered. But that one, it was, you know, it was a young man's bike, really. And so I thought, well, I advertised it for sale, and then a guy up in Scotland, I can't remember his name yet, emailed me and said, look, I've got an FX, the same as that, but full suspension one. Mm-hmm. Would you want to swap? So, and it was about the same age as the Vortex. Mm. So basically, we swapped it, really, and he got it sent down and I put it together. And yeah, that's how I've got the full suspension there.
The thing with the Trike, stuff falls out your pockets.
How do you lift the fairing up, Graham?
Just lift it forward.
Oh, that's it. That's it. That's better. All right. Lovely.
Good job I pumped the tyres up, wasn't it?
That's nice.
Wait, are you?
Oh, the brakes feel so nice. 20 inch all round. Let's take it for a ride and see what it's like. Tell you one thing, this bike is super comfortable. Lovely, Graham. All Graham's bikes run like a dream. Tiny gears before. Oh, look at that, snappy. Oh, not like mine. Oh, it handles well. Good old shredders. Very nice. I like it. It does take quite a bit of the wind off this fairing.
Yeah.
And you can see the road through it. First time I've ever ridden anything with one of these fairings on. So smooth. That's my first sort of impression of this thing. Oops, here's the comfort.
With my eyesight getting dodgier, I was losing the 3D effect on a two-wheeler, and I wasn't really enjoying it anymore, really. Mm-hmm. So that I thought, well, one day, I don't know what it was, me and Adrian went down to the bike shop. I can't remember what's his name, Stuart's bike shop.
Oh, Bike Fix.
Bike Fix, that's right. So we went down to Bike Fix and had a word with Stuart, and it was Adrian, really. I went down there. I'd seen them, but never really thought of them. So anyway, it was Adrian that got on, had a ride on it, and we went up and down, and I thought, I'll have a go. So we went up and down, and I thought, I like this.
Did you ride up the street?
Yeah, I walked up in front of his place.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Then I went up the very next couple of days and ordered one off him and bought it. And
what was that? What model was that?
That was the a Sprint. It was the I think it was just the normal Sprint with just the rear suspension, not an X on it. Funny thing was, I never told Adrian I was going to buy it because he was the first one interested in it. So I bought it and then went to pick it up from Stuart and went straight round to Adrian's house and knocked on the front door and he opened it.
You're a jaw dropping.
I'd got one. He was interested in it to begin with.
Brilliant.
So,
yeah. Shock.
And then I think not long after that, he got one of the very first X's that came out. And I thought, I'm not having that. So I bought X as well. So we had some of the first X's that they made. So that was good fun. So yeah, we used to do a lot of mileages together. That was good fun.
Mm-hmm.
Wide load. Really, really nice bike. Really nice. It'd be nice to go on a long ride with it one time. I enjoyed that. And super comfortable, Graham. That's first impression.
I'm sort of
really comfortable and really silent.
They are, that's what I mean. Once you get used to
the headrest is lovely.
Yeah.
Seat is amazing.
Yeah.
Works as it should. Lovely bike. Be really nice. What's it like going downhill pretty quick?
Awesome.
Quite stable.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, lovely bike.
You learn how to drift them. That's the good thing about these. When
does it keep your legs dry if it buckets down or most?
Yeah, no, that's the beauty of it. Yeah, I mean it keeps it drier.
Yeah, so just your jacket, you know what I mean? Really.
Yeah. The only problem is
you get it all flying off.
Yeah, well this is it. You go over a bump and it's like somebody throwing a bucket of water in your face because it all sort of lifts off.
Brilliant.
It's best just to kick it now again to get it off.
Yeah. Oh, it's lovely.
It's
thanks
awesome
for that, Graham. Really good. So that's the Ice FX. Lovely
bike.
That's
the full round suspension back.
And it's designed for a multitude of things, touring.
Mostly touring, I've got that set.
Yeah, it just strikes me as I just thought, I had a vision of myself in somewhere in France just ploughing through the miles all day, you know.
You can with these, you just plod along. If that's the beauty. If I go out on my own, I just forget to stop.
Yeah,
I get silly really. You've got to remember this one is a few years old, so
okay.
It's not the newer models.
Yeah.
It's a standard front rings there. You've got a 52 top, 39 and a 20 bottom.
Mm-hmm.
There's the normal sort of derailleur on it, like a normal bike. You've got the wind wrap, which basically, I'll tell you the truth, I think they're too expensive now.
Does it keep the wind off?
Oh, they're brilliant, yeah.
And the rain, a bit of the rain.
They don't make that much difference, really, unless you're doing a higher speed, low speeds. But it does actually cut through the wind. I like that.
What was that?
That's for the back wheel. The, what they call it?
Parking brake.
Parking brake. I couldn't think what the word. It's good because you can keep the parking brake in the dry, because when they're down here, they can be a little bit of a problem where they get wet and you have to change the cables quite often.
Corrode.
That stops that. It's got a back to front, which you can buy separately. I don't know if they fit more new now.
Okay.
Where it turns the bottle the other way around, so you can pull it out rather than having the bottle pointing the other way. I've got the newer ball joints on this one, where they've got the little rubber joints to stop the water from getting in.
They look like Velomobile ball joints.
They're quite hefty.
Yeah.
They do. You have to keep. What I do is just force a little bit of cycling grease in them from time to time.
They look like automotive ball joints. There you go.
They're quite heavy. Yeah. They're quite a good. They're self-lubricating, but I always shove a little bit of grease in there just to help them out.
Brake,
keeps the water out as well.
The brakes look quite meaty.
They're very good. Yeah. This one's hydraulic.
Okay.
Which
mineral oil?
Yeah, mineral oil. It's I love them. They're great. Yeah, you can stop on a 6 bits with those.
Okay. So you got trigger shift on the top.
Yeah, it's the normal. These are the original ones as well. They're really expensive to buy actually to replace. Shimano. They're not Shimano. What they call them?
SRAM.
SRAM. That's right. Panniers. They're the
ice branded.
Yeah, they're very good actually as well. Like just keeping the sandwiches in when you're long touring. It spreads the weight out when you're touring.
Keeps it all balanced.
Tanks, yeah.
And then you've got Ortlieb on the back.
That's right. They're nice and waterproof. This one's got the older rack as well. You can't buy these racks now because they don't actually make that as a fitment now.
Okay.
Because they've strengthened the swing arm on all the newer models. Not to say that wasn't any good, but it just stiffened them up a little bit.
Do you ever ride with the flag? Do you bother?
Yeah, all the time, yeah.
Okay.
I wouldn't be without it, yeah. I think that's a must, really.
Yeah.
Especially when you're coming down the side of cars.
Yeah, and traffic, yeah.
This one? This is the FX. This is the suspension all round.
Okay.
So it's got front suspension,
which actually I think is so well designed, because it doesn't take any pressure out of your, it doesn't take any momentum away. You know, as you as you pedal in, you'll find with a lot of suspension, the bike
pogoing
that is taking the you know the suspension away from you. But these, you don't lose anything at all. You know,
okay, so it's quite a firm ride.
Yeah, and you can adjust the firmness of it as well. So if you're going on a long tour or whatever, you can put
oh, fully adjustable.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah,
and the back is as well.
So depending on what you're carrying as well, like weight-wise.
Weight-wise, yeah. I mean, this one here has got a elastoplast in the back. I put the side bits on, which was... like something I did. You can't actually buy those. They're the velomobile ones,
so they're like wheel discs.
Yeah,
nice shredder tires all round, which I noticed earlier. Roll really well.
They're really well, yeah. And they're quite puncture resistant as well, although they're not puncture resistant, but I very rarely get a puncture in them.
Hello. Your bikes always amaze me. They're always immaculate compared to mine. Always, I ride mine to death, and then think, "Oh, that's broken. I better fix that." Whereas yours are always tip top.
Oh, I love. It's just something. I think I do it. Sort of, you know, if I keep them clean. I would say if you look after them, they look after you.
Yeah, yeah, you're right.
That, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
I've never had one let me down yet. Anywhere, you know.
So, is this model? Do they still make this model?
No, they don't make this particular. Why I quite like this one is because they've got the nice silver bits on it, you know what I mean? Whereby the newer ones, they don't, I think they're black now.
Yeah,
I don't think they're making like that.
They stand out a bit more. I like your lights on the back. What are they?
Oh, these are moon lights, yeah. They're extremely strong as well. They're very bright. You can have them flashing if you want as well.
Oh, yeah.
They're all, I think you just do that, and I think they flash.
Brilliant.
They're extremely bright then. Yeah. They last quite a few hours.
Are they USB?
Yeah, they're all USB, yeah.
And
yeah.
You've got a pocket here?
Yeah, it's a zip pocket where you can keep the actual seat cover in.
Okay, so what we got up there, Graham?
This is my...
looks quite sporty.
Well, it's what I used to call my road bike, really. Mm-hmm. Like, so with this particular one here, it's made up for touring, it's got extra weight. This one, I took as much weight as I could off. More mileage at a faster speed, if you get what I mean. It's a road bike, like a club bike, the club, you know, whacking around.
And so what is it?
This is an FX as well. This is an earlier model. This was literally weeks after it was actually brought out, this particular model.
Mm-hmm.
And again, it's all SRAM. Again, it's all the original parts on it. This one's got longer cranks. The Watura one's got shorter cranks on it.
Okay.
Because it's better on your knees.
So this has longer cranks?
It's got the longer cranks on it. So it was just stripped down as bare as I could. There's no suspension on the front of this one. Which is, I'm betwixt and between really, because with no suspension, you get to feel the ground better. In some respects, it's more exciting.
So you get a bit more feedback.
Yeah, you get more feedback. You can feel the ground and you can, you know, whack it round corners. Whereby this one here, the suspension brings the front up a couple of inches, so it just feels different. But they both have their, you know, niceties about them.
I like that one. That's my favourite.
It's always been my favourite.
Because it looks like super fast.
Yeah.
But you've got a little pump here. Is that a pump?
Yeah, it's a little pump on that one. I don't think I've ever used it.
Oh, I always like them when they have the numbers on the boom, so you always remember where it's set to.
Yeah.
22, 2018 wheel, and then it's got a disc as well.
Yeah, they're all discs. Like I say, this one's a cable, whereby this was hydraulics.
Okay, so that's all the brakes on that are cable operated.
Exactly.
Yeah. That one's hydraulic down there, as Graham said. We've got good old idlers under there. And here's the back end of the RS. It's X Sprint X. So it's 9 speed, X9, I think.
No, 10 speed.
10 speed.
10 speed, yeah. They're all 10 speeds.
Got a little green damper.
They're called plasters.
Okay.
And that's the suspension.
Like an elastomer.
Yeah, so that's what I think the name of the
plaster. Plaster.
Plaster, yeah. Elastoplast.
Elastoplast.
They're different. You get a red one, a green one, and a yellow one.
Mm-hmm.
Different sort of
for different injuries.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Lovely.
These are cable brakes on here.
This is a lot faster.
Oh yeah.
But I prefer the other one.
Yeah, no.
Other one is just feels more comfortable to me where everything's set. Yeah. And this one, you have a bit more movement due to the camber of the road, so you're sort of having to correct things. Whereas the FX,
I think it was. The suspension keeps it all.
It's just lovely. Yeah. You haven't got to sort of overthink anything. So at the moment, I'll go with the one. But this one's nice for a day ride.
That one.
Nice for a day ride, but I like, I'm old now, I like pooling along.
Oh, yeah, nice for it. Yeah, if you want a good fast club ride, that's
like if you think, 4 hour, really fast ride, jump in this.
I'm expecting a cut for it. There's a cat comes through here quite regularly. No. He makes funny noises. No. We call him Puffin' Willy.
Is he asthmatic?
No, he's got something wrong with him, I think. He just he puffs his way from here, disappears out in the garden. Yeah.
For people who are not in the know, which I think most of you do know a bit about ice trikes, they're based over here in the UK, in southwest, in Falmouth, I think it is, a small town in Cornwall. A guy called Chris runs the show, and he's got quite a few staff down there, and lovely guy, lovely company to deal with, from what I've heard. Well, I know Chris anyway, and he's a nice bloke, but I've heard that their customer service is second to none, so you can always check out Ice Trikes and go from there, really. And how have you found the company for when you need spares or bits
Brilliant.
And bobs?
I mean, the first bike I bought, like I said, I got it off of Stuart, and the next one, the FX, I bought one myself. The Vortex, I bought that in a box. I put it together myself.
From them?
But yeah, that's what I do. I'd recommend anybody to do that, really.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's quite easy to put together. But from the day one with ice, I mean, if I've had any problems whatsoever, just give them a ring and they'll solve it, send it in the post, anything that malfunctions, which is extremely rare, they'll replace it without any problems whatsoever.
Fantastic.
I've never had any problems with it. They're good to talk to on the phone.
And good the quality products?
You get what you pay for. I think they're a little bit pricey. I think really a lot of people are put off by the price. However, you get what you pay for. You really do with them bikes. I mean, they're all top end.
Brilliant.
All good quality.
Handmade.
I've done thousands of miles on these things. Only ever changed the old chain ring.
Things what generally wear on any bike.
Mostly. But the frames, brilliant. I had a bit of a problem with an earlier frame, the back end, but that was known, and they replaced it without any problem whatsoever. They sent a whole new one to put back.
Brilliant.
And that was done. But that doesn't happen in the new ones because they redesigned them.
Yeah.
So that was just a problem they had in manufacturing.
Lovely.
That, brilliant.
Excellent. What do you generally use the trikes for?
Bank robberies.
Robberies with violence.
Way fast. Yeah.
Drive-bys.
Fucking people, yeah.
Handbag snatching.
just general fun, really. You know, I like touring. The particular tour I can remember most was the Red Sprint I used to have.
Talk
and
a bit.
Louder. Yeah, louder. Shout! And, it was...
Project!
Project yourself. And I went round Kent. I did a tour around Kent. In fact, I just put a video on YouTube. It was redone by Paul. He stabilised it for me.
What's the name of your YouTube channel?
I don't know, it's got a name.
It's just Graham Williams.
Yeah, just Graham Williams.
Okay. Just for people who want to check it out.
Exactly. I set off on this red trike, and I mean, I had a great time going around the coast of Kent. And it wasn't till the last half that I got a puncture in the back. Worst place of all to get a puncture. And I'd done that. And then I got another puncture a couple of hours later. I thought, this is odd. So I checked the tyre, nothing wrong with the tyre. And I noticed then that it was underneath the tube. So it was the spoke side rather than the tyre side. And then finally I got another one. And I thought, this is, you know, because you're chucking new tubes in. I'm thinking, you know, I'm running out of tubes here.
You haven't gone far.
I'm going to have to repair these quick. So, what it turned out to be was, after pulling my hair out, you'll see it on the video, I really got harassed at one time, you know. And what it was the rim tape, and it was a nasty plastic rim tape. It was almost hard, and it got so brittle that the spokes were breaking through the rim tube into the tube. As soon as I put a high speed rubber one in, I did the rest of the tour, no problem whatsoever.
Do you have a spare rim tape with you?
No, I had to buy one. Lucky enough, I came across the shop that had a 20-inch for a 20-inch wheel, so I was so lucky.
Wow.
Yes, I was. Yeah. I thought it was me. I thought it was jinxed. I thought somebody was having a go at me.
Little pixie with the drawing pin. Running
Gremlin.
Up.
Yeah, I brought a gremlin with me. But that was quite fun.
So that's your favourite pastime?
That
then,
was my, yeah. That
with
was
the bikes,
favorite.
Touring.
I like to tour. Mm. But the longest I did was the Kent ride.
Wow. And then, it's hilly as well.
It wasn't too bad, funny enough. It had, mm-hmm. it had its moments, but the hillier one was I did a trip around Norfolk. Literally, I rode up to King's Lynn, and then I rode right the way round the coastline there.
Goodness.
That could become hilly, especially round by Cromer.
That's quite a few miles.
That was a good one. I mean, me and Barry did that one again a few years later, mm-hmm. which is on the video as well.
Yeah.
The longest, I think, overall ride is I rode from London up to King's Lynn, then King's Lynn down to Humber.
Jeez.
Went over the Humber Bridge.
How many miles in total do you reckon?
Oh, blimey, I lost count, to tell you the truth.
Mm-hmm. A few hundred, isn't it?
It was a few hundred, yeah, because I did a Susterings route as well, so okay. It takes you...
Meandering, yeah.
It don't take
you see all the nice bits.
It was brilliant. The only problem was towards the end, I got to the Humber Bridge, there's a really nice campsite, almost underneath the
really?
Bridge, yeah, just to one side. But it's lonely. I was on my own, mm-hmm. the weather wasn't great, and mm-hmm. I crossed the bridge, and I got to the other side of the bridge, and it was pouring rain, and I thought to myself, I want to go home.
As soon as you hit the north. What is your dream bike? If you could have any bike.
Yours.
Still
your Quattrovelo, yeah. No. Yeah. Like I say, as you know, I've had velo-ads.
Yeah, you've had that lovely manga, red and white one.
Oh, I love that thing. I miss that.
We went on quite a few rides together as well. Nice. Awesome.
Yeah, they're on video as well.
Good chuckle, yeah.
I think I did more mileage, longer mileage, in the manga than I did on the trikes.
Do you think that was just like just efficiency and comfort?
Yeah. Yeah. And I mean, it's
weatherproof,
really. Yeah, yeah, because you've got no. You're cutting through the wind. There's no resistance.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like on a trike. You get that resistance.
Yeah.
And I had the short cranks in there, and it was well geared.
Stay
out.
A bit drier as well.
Yeah.
This
no,
is what I like. I mean, I've ridden over here today in this. it's been raining
it's
non-stop.
Summer.
Yeah. I noticed online a month or two ago that you were doing quite a bit of writing. And do you want to tell us a little bit about that, or what you've been up to?
Yeah, writing, that's a strange one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anybody that knows me over the years was as surprised as I was, really. I just decided one day to sit down and write a book.
Amazing.
I found out I liked doing it. Yeah.
Wow.
So, now, like I say, I've just published my third one.
It's your third now.
I'm thinking about a fourth one. Now. But they're so time-consuming, you get a struggle between sitting in a room, in a back room, you know. I got a routine, I write in the mornings, and then mm-hmm. I afternoon. But you struggle between riding a bike. I'd rather be out there,
yeah.
Do you get what I mean, than sitting in that room there.
Yeah.
And it does, it is a struggle in the end.
I noticed.
It's a relief when you get to the end. But it's a buzz in itself. When they're published, and I mean, I can't read my own books, but I get the smell of them. So when I get
And what's the title of the first three?
The first one is the
first
Jug
one,
and
sorry.
Hare Bathhouse.
Sorry, what's that?
Jug and Hare Bathhouse.
Okay.
Is the first one.
And what's that one about?
Blimey.
Briefly.
Briefly. I don't know how to explain it, really. It's best if people read it.
Yeah, yeah. It's set in, like, nowadays?
It's set in the 16th century.
Really. Okay.
Yeah, it's James the First. And it's a whodunit, in a way.
Okay.
And the second book is also... It's a continuation with the same characters, really, just adventures mm-hmm. they have. during that period in medieval time.
What's the title of the second one?
Do you know, I was just trying to think. I was hoping he wouldn't ask me that.
It's the tequila.
He doesn't even know the name of his album.
Jug and Hair Bathhouse, yeah, part two.
Basically. I think it's, if I remember right, it's called Sheeps, Wasps and the King.
That's it.
There's three stories within it.
Mm-hmm.
And then, but the one I like the most, but they're all standalone books, but mm-hmm. it's best read all three from the first one on, because then the third one is a combination of the two previous stories, so it makes more sense, but you can read it as a standalone book. But I enjoyed that, and that's the longest one.
Wow.
And that was a struggle, because I had to write to a defined end, if you mm-hmm. know what I mean. I had to end all the characters and bring all the characters back in again. I had to reread the first two, make sure it was all right.
Yeah.
And, so it was, that
not
was
all work. Work,
but I was pleased. I was pleased when that one came to an end, but I feel I learned so much mm-hmm. writing the first two that the third one is...
Was it easier in a way?
In a way, yeah. Because by then I knew all the characters. Mm-hmm. And but it's a strange thing, when you sit down, the struggle is trying to bring it to an end because the characters take over.
You don't want it to end yet.
You do and you don't. I miss them now. I mean, mm-hmm. now I've brought it to an end, I actually miss the characters.
Wow.
They're part of you. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But you struggle because they have a life of their own after a while.
Yeah.
You sit there writing and they take you to some funny places.
Amazing.
You have to sort of drag them back to the narrative for the story.
Brilliant. Wow.
So yeah, that was good fun.
Wow, that sounds great. So yeah, check them out. Check out the books online if you're interested. Maybe Graham can do you a deal.
I do sign copies on. I've just sent one to Kelly, the
fun print
guy. Yeah, he said sign it. So it's
brilliant.
Quite funny the amount of people that want a signed copy. Mm-hmm. So I don't mind. But I was a bit shocked by the price of the postage. I think he was too.
Shouldn't have used such heavy ink.
Exactly.
What's your plans for the future? Are you going to continue writing? Maybe get a little bit more riding in? Or do a tour, one last hurrah?
Well, I was thinking of that. I mean, I'm even thinking about this year, because I've still got all my camping gear and the trailer. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I've got the trailer to go on the back. And I can hear thunder.
Yeah.
Is that thunder or is that...
That's thunder, yeah.
And, so I am thinking about a last hurrah, really.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think if I don't do one this year, I might not be able to do one next year, because the way my eyesight's deteriorating.
Yeah.
The future, that's why I started writing in a way, because if I can't carry on with the bikes, then that gives me something else to do, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Who knows?
You know, you've got a few trikes there, and if you want a bit of annoying company, I don't mind riding one of them behind you for a few miles.
Can you get a tandem velomobile?
You can get the Milan for two, and you can get the side by side.
That's the side by side.
Yeah, Denis in France is making them. He's designed and built one. He was on Gary Solomon's show showing it off recently.
Right, okay. Yeah, I was actually looking at one of them, and I really would like, because like I say, with Barry sitting beside me, that would be hilarious.
Yeah, and either one can steer because it's in the middle. So
is
you
it
just
really?
Yeah, it's like a joystick.
Oh, cool.
So you can say you drive for a bit, and I'll eat a sandwich.
Oh no, I'll let him drive. Otherwise,
and there's it looks like a quattro velo in a way, because you've got the big space for either a kid.
I've seen them. I've dribbled over the